Driving talk of a Palin presidential bid is the fact that the governor dined earlier this evening with real estate mogul Donald Trump right here in New York City. So does Governor Palin have something up her sleeve? Joining me with reaction, Fox News contributor Andrea Tanteros, and from the Young America's Foundation, the one and only Kate Obenshain. All right. I really don't know.
I think she doesn't know. I mean, I think she's being genuine. Obviously, Sarah Palin is considering her children and her family first. We know that about her. I've met her, and I was struck by the fact that that is her primary concern, and she knows what her children go through. But that is an obstacle, but it's also her reason for wanting to be involved and possibly wanting to run for president. So I think she's still in the decision-making
process. What do you think, Andrew?
I would be very shocked if she got in at this stage. But look, I think that
she's leaning towards doing it.
Well, because, and I wouldn't be surprised if she did get in the race. I mean, this right. Sarah Palin always has something up her sleeve. So whether she's leading the media on a wild goose chase, only to dump them like Donald Trump did, which I really thought was hilarious. She's making them nuts, which is great. But also, I think if you're a Republican candidate, you're thanking her. I mean, Newt Gingrich, best thing that ever happened to him is she's running interception, all these stories. Sean, no one wants to be the front runner right now. Mitt Romney can quietly raise money behind the scenes. The only one it might affect is Tim Pawlenty or those who don't have higher name ID. He came out today and said, let's get off these bus tours.
Yeah, but the other thing is she's forcing the conservative, all the candidates to be a little bit more conservative. Take the issue that she came out today and said there should be no more ethanol subsidies. Mitt Romney has said there should be ethanol subsidies. And she is saying, let the free market decide that this has been a prop up for the ethanol industry.
It's not going to help her in Iowa.
And that's okay. You know, with Palin, she's shooting straight. She's unorthodox. She is, people love to say that she's polarizing. But you know who else was polarizing? Ronald Reagan.
Yeah, no,
he said what people didn't always like to hear, but he said,
I paid for this microphone.
That's exactly it.
And she does need one of those moments, Sean. She really does need one of those Ronald Reagan, I paid for those microphone moments. But you look at it, what's the downside of her doing this? Whether she's trying to better the brand or better the balance sheet back at Sarah Palin, Inc., the woman knows.
You know what? I don't think she's
helping her.
Could it be as simple as what she's saying it is?
Yeah.
That she wants to raise awareness about founding principles and I'm going to these historic sites?
It absolutely could. And think about it. If you're a Republican candidate, you know you have to get her approval if she doesn't jump in to run for office.
And, you know, there's just such cynicism about Sarah Palin. Why is she doing this? Everybody tries to figure out how she's manipulating. She is a genuine woman. She means what she says. She's doing this.
Listen, this is the thing that interested me, because I'm following all this press coverage of this, and is this a presidential campaign?
Yeah.
And it's driving the media nuts.
I think there was
an article on Drudge. The media says they feel like they're the paparazzi. That's their problem.
You know,
here's the point. She has deep convictions about the Constitution, the direction of the country. She has an impact if she sends out a tweet, a Facebook post.
I think that what's coming up next, I guess next month, this documentary about Sarah Palin by Steve Bannon.
I saw it too. All right.
And I think what she needs to do is prove that she has some intellectual firepower. And I think she also has to, or this documentary, which she did not actually produce, I think that it has to show that she had a good reason for stepping down from the governorship. If she
That's
can do those
question.
Two things,
I agree. That is
I think she might have a good shot.
You're right, Kate. I mean, she does need that gravitas. And that's the one thing that she just doesn't have. I mean, look at what Ronald Reagan did. He did his own research and delivered his own radio addresses each week on a very serious, substantive topic. She has yet to do that. It's more the one-offs on Twitter. It's more the one-offs on
Facebook. I wouldn't say that she hasn't done it yet, but people know nothing about her governorship. They don't understand what she accomplished in 18 months was unheard of. She actually slashed the budget during a surplus. Do you know how hard that is to do? What it requires to be able to convince both sides to be able to do that?
They talked about that when she was VP.
I don't think so. I don't think people realize what she did in terms of getting the pipeline.
What do you make of the Donald Trump?
That's the little stuff.
What do you make of the Donald Trump? That's interesting to me.
It's very interesting. They're both master media manipulators. And the media both has...
Come on, I take that as a compliment.
Look, Donald Trump, he knows how to use the media for his purposes. So does she. And you know what? Good for her.
Yeah,
they have treated her. She doesn't owe them anything. Frankly, it's a fatal attraction, obsession that they have with her. And she's saying, you're going to follow me
no matter what I do.
I think it was Rush who said this, Rush Limbaugh. And I think his observation was dead on. is she has grown to the point where she embraces the fact that they hate her.
That's exactly
And she
yeah.
knows the rules. She defines the playing field in terms of how the game is played. And it drives them nuts. They feel like they're paparazzi.
It drives them crazy that after 3 years of steadily attacking her, I mean, more brutally than perhaps anyone's been attacked, she comes back stronger every single time.
I mean, people have got to see that. Interesting. Even if maybe you were a critic of Governor Palin or you bought into the hype, you know, the fact that she doesn't go away, she keeps fighting and standing up for what she believes in. Here's the next question. If she runs, can she win?
Once, I agree with John McCain. I agree with him on a couple things. But he said today, absolutely she can. She has been consistently underestimated. And again, we have to look at the other guy who people said were...
Bill Clinton, you know...
Hussein Obama. Right. If there's a no-name with very little experience
Reagan
in the White House, you just need to look at our current commander-in-chief. Anything can happen.
But look,
we've seen politicians have high negatives like she has and bring them down.
Well, look at where the country was in 1980. We were looking for someone who paints with without pale pastels, but bold colors, who says it the way it is. And right now, we're in a very similar economic situation.
Sounds like Kate Obenshain is going to, you want her to
No, I am fat. Yeah, I kind of do because I think, actually, I really do because I think
you?
She pushes.
I want her to
I think
run.
She
pushes,
she energizes the contest. She gets conservatives
Let
enthused and active. She holds not only Republicans accountable, but the Democrats.
I love that it drives the arrogant Washington elites.
That nuts. And the media.
I love that.
And the misogynist training camp across the street, the other network, it makes them absolutely bonkers. It brings out the worst side of them, and that's what she does best without even trying.
Yeah. Guys, good to see you both. Appreciate it.